हेलो गाइस, दिस इज निडमिस्ट एंड एज यू कैन सी टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अनबॉक्स अ प्लास्टिक जनरेशन बी ब्लेड विच इज नन अदर देन ड्रॉन्जर वी टू। सो इफ यू गाइस डोंट नो ऑलरेडी, ड्रॉन्जर वी टू स्टैंड्स फॉर ड्रॉन्जर वॉल्केनो 2। इट इज अ अपग्रेड टू द प्रीवियस ड्रॉन्जर वॉल्केनो विच आई ऑब्वियसली नेवर अनबॉक्स एंड आई डेफिनेटली प्लान टू अनबॉक्स। प्रीवियस टू ड्रॉन्जर वॉल्केनो वी हैव ड्रॉन्जर फ्लेम which I had unboxed in the previous to previous video. So if you definitely haven't checked out this video, go in the description and the link is there. So definitely check out the unboxing of Dronzer Flame. It is one of the iconic Beyblades which Kai keeps in a shelf during the V-Force, at the start of the V-Force, because he is too bored and cannot find a worthy opponent. So hence this power of Dronzer F has been locked out in the starting of V-Force, and hence later on, once he meets Danga, it unleashes Kai's wrath and the excitement for blading, because Danga is a very powerful opponent for him and a great match. So that's the story of Dronzer F. So definitely check out the unboxing. Moving on to today's video, we have Dronzer Volcano 2. So this Beyblade was made when Kai's Dronzer Volcano was brutally tortured and then tattered into, like, broken into pieces by King and Queen. So those were the parts hunters which simultaneously attacked Kai in a battle, leading to Kai's defeat, and all the parts of Dronzer V, which is Volcano, were shattered and left there to rust out, and thus we have Dronzer V2 afterwards born from that, where Kenny used Dronzer V as the base for the making and then made this one, Dronzer V2. Sorry for the box falling there. This is the Bit Beast here, A81. So this Beyblade is from Takara Tomy, obviously, and the condition of the box is really good. That is very rare. And this is actually the Beyblade from where you can have the final drive system, where you, like, the origin of final drive. So once we get through the box, I would just show you what I'm talking about. So be sure to check out the entire video properly, because it has lots of details for the final drive system. As you can see, it's a booster, so you only have this and a huge pamphlet with it. I don't know why, but we would just go through it as well, because these unboxings, the plastic generation ones, have a lot of information in them. So yeah, it's okay, fine, we can just rip it apart. This is a generic Bitbeast sticker, so it doesn't matter. The original sticker sheet of Dronzer V2, really cool. Dronzer V2 in this form looks a lot scarier, if you can see, compared to the previous form. So as you can see, it's more flary and all. I don't know why, but yeah, it got upgraded. So instruction manual doesn't matter. And yep, this is something we call as a Beyblade chart, or you can say a big size pamphlet, where you get all the information of the products by Takara Tomy. And this time, yes, it's Duel Masters. So I hope you guys know what is Duel Masters, right? Duel Masters was one of the card games which was very popular. And then you have what is this? I believe that's Beetaman. Yeah, it's that Beetaman. So Beetaman is also one of the animes which is very popular. It is also a game like Beyblade itself. Yes, you have marbles and all, shooting things in it. And then at the back of the box, you have the electric, first electric versions of Beyblades, where you have the control system. I had unboxed this previously. Okay, so very cool kind of a pamphlet, giving all the information of different products, because most of the people don't know about all the products, so it gives you a gist of it. So moving again back to the original Beyblade now. Dronzer V2 has a very different color compared to Dronzer F. So you can clearly see that this is a different kind of blue, whereas this one is a completely darker one. This one is light. So you have the attack ring, or you can say the energy ring, which is the Dronzer V2 one. Looks really cool, has a slight slope towards it, and that is why this is one of the most competitive stock Beyblades along with Drigger V2. Like the Beyblade stock itself is so damn competitive and so damn good that it, when it's modified, gets you to a next level. But only being stock also, it's very competitive. I have battled with it previously when I didn't have a NIB version like this. That time I was not able to buy these things directly, and I just snapped off one of the frames here. But anyways, this is the pit chip, the support parts, the core parts, and yep, finally the MG core. Let's see if this one is in good condition or like the previous one which we had unboxed. Okay, so yes guys, this one is in good condition. The box itself was in a very smooth and nice condition, and the MG core itself also is in very good condition. Let's check it out with the knife. Yeah, it's proper, it's proper. So there you have it, the MG core properly there, and let's put up the rest of the parts now. It's a bit difficult to, it's difficult, but it's at the same time a lot of fun to assemble these Beyblades, because as I always say in this unboxings, these Beyblades have a lot of substance and a lot of parts in them. So yeah, it's difficult, but yeah, have to go off screen sometimes. Yep, so this is the core which is formed now. Okay, so now let's go to the base. Yep, we have installed it in the base. The support clips. One, if the Beyblade is like very in very good condition, then the parts like the NIB ones, it is very difficult to assemble sometimes, and as it's plastic, it's scary to apply a lot of force, because a single wrong misdirection here and there can snap the Beyblade in two. Okay, so this is quite difficult now. I'm literally shaking with the force which I'm trying to apply, but it's, yeah, done finally. So the core is in position. Now for the support ring of the base, it should go something like this, I believe. Yep, that's the support ring of the base. So this is the base, which is as you can see, well rounded, and that's the final drive springs and all. It's got a real competitive value. So let's just assemble and first see the Beyblade without any stickers, and then as always we'll be back after some time with the stickers. So this is Dronzer V2 with no stickers. Looks really good, really competitive, really strong, and one of the best Beyblades available. So yes guys, I'll be back now applying the stickers, so stay tuned guys. Yes guys, I'm back with all the stickers on Dronzer V2, which is Dronzer Volcano 2, and now it's simply beautiful. I really hoped someday that this kind of Beyblades were Exactly like the animes where the ring was actually all metal and all, and on that they had the quartz. But anyways, this is plastic, and any battles with this can lead to serious damages. So this Beyblade will just stay like this in mint condition always and forever, unless and until I maybe someday decide to sell this out at a superiorly high price, definitely for sure. Because I am the one who has unboxed it and I know the condition exactly. So Dronzer V2, Dronzer F, Dronzer V is remaining, and then the a headline is damn difficult to get, but definitely we'll try someday, some point later. And till the next video, guys, take care and bye bye.